Welcome to another video on vocabulary. My name is Preetinder Kaur and here is my email address. And you can stay connected with me through the page on Facebook. So I'll go ahead and describe some common word groups in this video that can be used in tests such as GRE and SAT. So the first word group that we are going to learn is that of pacify. So all these words can be used in the place of pacify, like ameliorate, appease, assuage, mitigate, mollify, placate, propitiate, satiate, slake, and soothe. Although some of these words may not exactly mean pacify, but yes, you can use them in the same sense, and at least it will help you to find out whether the word given to you will fit in the blank or not. So moving forward, the next word group is that of boring. So you can use a lot of these words such as banal, fatuous, hackneyed, insipid, mundane, pedestrian, trite, quotidian, prosaic, and platitude. And remember, insipid is specifically used for food that does not have any taste, which is very bland. You can use insipid for that, and take care not to confuse prosaic with mosaic. Mosaic is a totally different word. Prosaic means something that is boring, you've done every day, so it becomes so routine that now it's not interesting anymore. The next word group is that of words that mean harmful. So you have baleful, baneful, deleterious, inimical, insidious, minatory, perilous, pernicious. So all these words can be used in place of harmful. The next word group is that for lazy. So the words that come under the word group of lazy are indolent, inert, lackadaisical, languid, lassitude, lethargic, phlegmatic, quiescent, slothful, and torpid. And you can also use some of these words in place of a casual attitude or something that's not very serious, like lackadaisical or callous. So you can use these words as well. The next word group is that for criticize, and you have a lot of words under this word group as it's a very important one, and you find a lot of these words on the GRE and the SAT both. So you have words like aspersion, belittle, berate, castigate, and belittle, berate, castigate are all used in the form of words. Calumny, decry, defamation, objurgate, opprobrium, pillory, rebuke, remonstrate, vituperative, and on this side you have deride, diatribe, disparage, excoriate, gainsay, harangue, impugn, inveigh, lambast, reprehend, reprove, revile, tirade, and denounce. So all these words can be used in place of criticize. The next word group is of hatred. So the words that come here are abhorrence, anathema, antagonism, antipathy, detestation, enmity, loathing, malice, odium, and rancor. So all these words can be used in place of hatred and have a negative connotation to them. And the words that are good, generous, those are like altruistic, beneficent, clement, largesse, magnanimous, munificent, philanthropic, and unstinting. So all these have a positive connotation to them. The next word group is when a person denies himself. For example, abnegate, abstain, stoic, ascetic, Spartan, temperate. Not spending too much in terms of money or other material gifts on one's own self. And the words which come under the word group of innocent are credulous, gullible, ingenuous, naive, novitiate, and tyro. And remember, novitiate and tyro can also be used for someone who is a beginner and as well for someone who is very innocent. The next word group is for falsehood. You have words like guile, mendacious, perfidious, prevaricate, specious, spurious, apocryphal, canard, chicanery, dissemble, duplicity, equivocate, erroneous, ersatz, fallacious, and feigned. So all these words mean that something is not correct, it's deceitful, or it's false. The next word group is based on death. So words that surround death are macabre, moribund, obsequies, sepulchral, wraith, bereave, cadaver, defunct, demise, dolorous, elegy, knell, and lament. And lament is used for someone who creeps crying. So lamenting is the act of crying. So you can use that in the same sense. The next word group is that for forgive, absolve, acquit, exonerate, exculpate, expiate, palliate, redress, vindicate. So all these words referring to giving mercy. The next word group is for disgusting, and words that come in this group are defile, fetid, invidious, noisome, odious, and putrid. And the next word group is easy to understand. The words that come under this word group are articulate, cogent, eloquent, evident, limpid, lucid, and pellucid. And remember, lucid and pellucid can also be used for something that is very clear and not at all difficult. The next word group is for embarrass. So words like abash, chagrin, compunction, contrition, diffidence, expiate, foible, gaucherie, and rue come under this word group. And another group of words that refer to being greedy are avaricious, covetous, mercenary, penurious, rapacious, and venal. Again, I'm mentioning all of these words may not exactly have greedy as their meaning, but yes, you can give them a connotation of being greedy so that it can help you in some of the questions. Now the next group is that for beginner. So you have dilettante, fledgling, neophyte, novitiate, proselyte, and tyro. And if you remember, I had already told you in the video that novitiate and tyro can be used for beginner as well as innocent. And some more words for beginner are burgeoning, which is growing, callow, engender, inchoate, callow again, incipient, and nascent. The next word group is for abbreviated, when you shorten something: abridged, compendium, cursory, curtail, syllabus, synopsis, and terse. The next word group again for terse, compendious, curt, laconic, pithy, succinct, and taciturn. Taciturn is also used for lazy. Tacit and taciturn are synonyms of each other. For sorrow, we have another word group, and the words that come under this group are disconsolate, doleful, dolor, elegiac, forlorn, lament, lugubrious, melancholy, morose, plaintive, and threnody. The next word group is that for stubborn, and the words under this word group are implacable, inexorable, intractable, intransigent, obdurate, obstinate, recalcitrant, refractory, and renitent. The next word group is for weaken, so the words that you can use to weaken something: inhibit, obviate, stultify, undermine, enervate, vitiate, and exacerbate. Now you may think that there are some words like obviate that have come under more than one word group. That's because they have meanings that are not exactly the same as the word group, but still you can make an idea of the word. Otherwise it will be very difficult to learn the exact meanings of all these words, and that is the purpose that word groups solve. So moving on to the next word group is biting. Biting in the terms of comments or remarks: asperity, acerbic, acidulous, acrimonious, caustic, mordacious, mordant, and trenchant. The next one is wisdom. So the words that come under this group are adage, aphorism, apothegm, axiom, bromide, dictum, epigram, platitude, sententious, and truism. And these were the word groups. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll be bringing on a new video with some more vocabulary to learn. Thank you for now.